In this video, we're building the Cheater Buster automation with n8n and Home Assistant, using Frigate to task an AI that analyzes interactions and instantly sends you the evidence if it detects intimate behavior. Now, let's build the automation workflow. Our starting point, as is often the case when integrating with Home Assistant events, has to be a webhook. Since n8n can't directly trigger off a Home Assistant sensor change, the webhook gives us a unique URL that Home Assistant can call to instantly kick off our investigation. We'll set the method to post and give it a custom path like busted. The moment that webhook is triggered, we need to start our surveillance patrol. But a single snapshot is useless. It's too easy to miss the critical moment. We need to watch for a period of time. That brings us to our first node inside the workflow, edit fields. But we're using it to do something clever. We're creating a list of 7 numbers called loop count. Why 7? 2 reasons. First, intimate behavior might not happen instantly, so a loop gives us multiple chances to observe. Second, cost. Every check uses the AI's API, which costs money. 7 is a good balance between persistent observation and not breaking the bank. This list is the fuel for our patrol. It tells the system we're going to conduct 7 rounds of checks. Now, to actually use that list, we need the split out node. Its job is to take our list of 7 numbers and break it into 7 individual parallel processes. In the configuration, we just put loop count in the field to split out and select no other fields. This turns our plan to check 7 times into 7 actual tasks ready to go. But if we let them run now, they'd all happen at once. That's not a patrol, that's a flash mob. To force them into a single file line, we use the loop over items node. But by setting the batch size to 1, we create a perfect loop. It lets one task go, waits for it to complete its entire journey and come back, and only then does it release the next one. This is the core of our patrol logic. Okay, the patrol has begun. What does round 1 look like? First, we need to see what's happening right now. That's the job of the call a service node, rename get a screenshot. In the configuration, we set the domain to camera and the service to snapshot. We then add 2 attributes, a file name with a custom name for our picture and the entity ID of our spy camera. We have to do this at the start of every loop because a picture from a minute ago is already old news. This node is our eyes, providing the fresh, real-time evidence for our AI. But here's a crucial intermediate step. The snapshot service in Home Assistant only saves the picture to a file path. It doesn't pass the image data directly into our workflow. To actually get that image file into n8n so our AI can see it, we need to add a new node, an HTTP request node, which I'll rename download picture. Its job is simple. It performs a GET request to the specific URL where Home Assistant stores that new snapshot. The most important setting is under Options. We set the response format to File. This tells n8n to download the image as binary data, which is exactly what our next node needs. With a new snapshot downloaded and in hand, it's time for judgment. We send the image to the AI agent node, which I've renamed Behavior Analysis, and use Google Gemini. The prompt here is the soul of the project and has to be surgically precise. I've instructed the AI, you are a professional security analyst. Your job is to detect specific, ongoing, intimate physical contact, like kissing or inappropriate touching. Ignore normal interactions. If you see clear evidence, output the number 1. If it's innocent or ambiguous, output the number 0. Nothing else. This turns a general AI into a cold, unbiased specialist. Now, with a verdict of 0 or 1 in hand, we reach the if1 node. This is the moment of truth. The rule is simple. Does the AI's output equal 1? If the answer is true, the system has found what it's looking for. The workflow will shoot down the true path to trigger our final alarm, and the patrol ends immediately. If the answer is false, the patrol continues. The workflow follows the false path to our wait node. Here, we'll set the amount to 1 and the unit to minutes. This means after each clean check, the system will pause for a full minute. This node defines our patrol frequency. Without it, all 7 checks would complete in a matter of seconds, defeating the purpose of continuous monitoring. It's this pause that ensures our AI analyst gets to reevaluate the scene with a fresh pair of eyes every minute, dramatically increasing the probability of catching the specific behavior we're looking for. After that minute is up, we need to ask a critical question before we waste more API calls. Are there still 2 people in the room? That's the job of the person count node. It's a simple home assistant node that gets the current state of our Frigate person count sensor. Why? To avoid useless loops. If the guests have left, there's no point in continuing the patrol. This node is our mission abort check. The result of that check goes to our final logic gate, the if2 node. Its rule is simple. Does the current person count still equal 2? If true, it loops all the way back to our loop over items node to start the next round of snapshot, analyze, wait. If false, the threat is gone, the workflow hits a dead end, and the patrol is safely terminated. This is our braking system, saving us from a runaway automation. Now let's go back to that if1 node's true path, the moment the AI outputs a 1. The workflow immediately triggers our final action, the notification node. This time, I'm not using a standard Home Assistant node. I'm still using a more powerful HTTP request node. In the configuration, the method is post. The URL points directly to my Home Assistant's Notify Service API for my phone. Authentication is header off with my credentials. And in the body, I've crafted a JSON payload with a message, cheater busted, and a data field with an image path pointing to the snapshot we just took. This sends the damning evidence, the actual picture, directly to my phone. Game over. The loop terminates. Finally, to make this all work, we need to tell Home Assistant how to trigger that initial webhook. In Home Assistant configuration file, create a REST command and paste in the production URL from your n8n webhook. Then, in the automation's UI, create a new one. The trigger is your Frigate person count sensor state changing to 2. The action is simply to call the REST command you just made. And that's the complete system. When 2 people are detected, the n8n patrol begins. If the AI detects intimate behavior, it sends the evidence and stops. If not, it patrols up to 7 times, stopping only if the coast is clear. I've put together a full guide with the workflow and every snippet from today's video. The link is in the description. I get my best ideas from you, so please drop a comment with what you'd like to see next. Thanks again for your time. Every like and subscribe makes a huge difference and keeps this channel going. Until next time, happy automating!